once upon a future time in a place called Stardust Bay. Counting down to adventure now. Rockets on a mission, we're on.
Be right?
What is it?
These numbers just don't add up.
Well, I'm pretty good with calculations. Maybe I can help. What are you working on?
I'm trying to discover a new exoplanet.
What's an exoplanet?
Many stars have planets orbiting them just like our sun does. These planets are called exoplanets because exo means outside, as in outside our solar system.
But why do you need to discover them? Can't you just look through the telescope to see them?
Well, if only it were that easy. These planets are so far away, it's impossible to see them, even with our most powerful telescope.
Then how do you...
We wait for the planet to pass in front of the star. Here, let me show you. Watch what happens when I pass this model planet in front of the light.
The light blink!
That's right! And watch this! Bigger planet, bigger blink!
Neato!
And by measuring how big a blink we see every time it passes in front of the star, we can tell how big the planet is!
Then what's the problem with the numbers?
Well, the measurement is telling me there's a big planet close to the star. But usually it's the smaller ones that are closest to the stars.
So why is there a big planet so close?
Aha! My question exactly.
Professor Coot, you have to help me. You have to help me, please.
Starling, what seems to be the problem? Class doesn't start for half an hour.
I lost Mr. Rocket Baby. I thought maybe I left him in here.
Oh, your doll. Starling, I'm pretty sure Mr. Rocket Baby isn't in the lab. When things are hard to find, they're often right in front of you.
If Mr. Rocket Baby were right in front of me, wouldn't I be seeing him right now?
Good point.
Gotta find him. Thanks, Professor. Oh, Mr. Rocket Baby, where are you?
But why is it so important to dig in deep craters at the lunar pole?
Because that's the only place where water ice could be stable on the moon, even without an atmosphere.
Ah, yes, I see. That could be a very valuable discovery. But in order for me to approve this mission, you'll need some source of light. Or I'm afraid it will be too dangerous for the cadets to go digging around in the dark.
What do you say, Coot? Can you shed some light on the situation?
What situation?
Can you set up a light source for Pigeon so he can have the class dig in the lunar caverns?
Oh, sure. It's a simple matter of using the sun. We can position a large mirror so it will bounce sunlight into the cavern.
Great. Done and done.
No way. We won.
How can you say you won when we scored the winning goal?
Because you went out of bounds. That goal didn't count.
It's weird that you think that because I was clearly in bounds when I scored the winning goal. Ergo, we won.
Okay, cadets. What seems to be the problem?
Raven and Eagle are arguing about who won the big Orbo match last week.
Professor Coot, see for yourself. Look at the video and you'll see that Eagle was clearly out of bounds.
Okay, yes. Well, I will definitely have to add that to my to-do list. But now, class has started, and today we are going to learn about exoplanets. Remember your homework? I'll need to see your research on exoplanets by Monday. So much work to do. Where was I? Oh, yes. First, I'll need to borrow a glass lens from a large telescope. Then, if I add some shiny metal sheeting, it should provide the reflective surface I need. Now, where did I leave that sheet metal? Probably in the supply shed. What on earth are you two doing?
We're playing tag with Raven.
Well, okay then, carry on.
Look,
that shadow, it's Raven-shaped.
Nice try, Raven.
Tag, you're it.
Missed me.
Starling, so, did you find your Mr. Rocket Baby?
No, I did what you said. I looked right in front of me everywhere I went. But I still can't find Mr. Rocket Baby.
Say, why don't you try looking at things from a different perspective? You know, in a way you haven't tried before. Maybe that'll help.
Oh, okay, Professor.
One mirror as requested.
Launch sequence initiated in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Primary ignition.
Booster rockets.
Escape.
Wings.
Yeah.
Space visors.
Go. Blast off.
And now, Hawk, if we position this mirror just right, the light from the sun will shine on it and then bounce off into that deep moon crater so you'll have enough light to work.
Tag, you're it.
Hey, be careful, you two. Hawk, please help me readjust the mirror.
Okay, cadets. Now, today's mission is to gather rock samples from this cavern and see if we can detect any water ice. Don't be afraid to get your wings dirty.
What's this? Two cadets lined up in the same path, creating a bigger shadow than either of them could alone. Eureka! That's it!
Where's Coot going?
I have no idea.
Ava, please, show me my current prediction about the exoplanet that's circling star NCC-1701. Now, what if instead of a large planet, there were two smaller planets? No. One planet is closer to the star, and the other a little farther out. Now, what if those two planets just happened to line up and block the star from our point of view at the exact same time? Would that match the numbers I've been measuring?
Affirmative. In that case, the data would match your readings exactly.
Then I've done it! I didn't just discover one new planet. I've probably discovered two. Oh, I'll have to tell Headmaster Crane about this.
Mr. Rocket Baby, are you in here? Ooh, what's that? Oh, where are you?
Still no luck, huh?
I've looked everywhere. I'm afraid Mr. Rocket Baby is gone for good.
Well, don't give up just yet. Here, let me help you. Let's go back to where you last saw Mr. Rocket Baby.
In my room.
Well, that's a good place to start. Come. Where have you looked so far?
I've searched everywhere.
Well, when that doesn't work, you have to try looking in different ways.
Like how?
Okay. How about this? Try looking with one eye closed.
This isn't working.
Well, keep trying other things. Try looking with a mirror, or in the dark, or with a magnifying glass.
Maybe I should just try standing on my head.
Sure, why not? Give it a shot.
This is really weird. Everything looks so strange. I don't think this is working. I don't see Mr. Rocket Baby. Oh, I found you. Thank you, Professor
in a day's work.
It is my pleasure to announce that our dear friend Coot has discovered not one, but possibly two new exoplanets. In his honor, we will name these planets Coot 1 and Coot 2.
Yay!
Thank you. I humbly accept this great honor, but I couldn't have done it without all your help. You see, I never would have looked at things from a different angle to solve my problem if it weren't for Starling, Eagle, Hawk, and Raven.
Speaking of which, where is Raven anyway?
Tag, you're it.
Ooh, I'm gonna get you!